What's going on? It's Cash from KrashPackGaming, and this is another late night recording sesh. Get back into some Darksiders 3. This will be a season, episode 11 of season 1, which means the next episode will be the last episode before we take a little hiatus from the game. If you're new to the channel and this is the first time, I decided to do this whole season thing to keep myself from burning out on the game and to give more content pushed out to the channel. Yes, this means we finish games slower, but it also means we have more flavor on the channel. Anyways, let's continue. I know the last episode was kind of short. Well, not really short. Maybe like a couple minutes short. Anyways, now we're gonna get into this. What is it? Who is that big mofo? Tell me there's a mini boss over here. I came to fight the big boy. Sorry if I got quiet right there. That was a large bombardment of enemies. Yeah, you gotta know something about these eggs. They say they'll birth little baby chicks. And you got all these stupid bugs. Just annoying. Oh, maybe you can hear me better. I moved closer to my microphone. Yo, look at that. It's crazy. So, looks like we got to crawl in another hole. Okay, so we have our wraith form and our wraith attack, because this is definitely going to be a boss. This is Slime Core. Yeah, what'd I tell you? Let's try to get the... Let's try to get the arcane counter. Heal. Yes. Okay. That wasn't that bad. I don't feel like that was a mini boss either, though, so. A demonic artifact. Hey, hey, hey. But, like, we knew we were gonna fight that because we just saw it, right? So, whew. It's pretty nice that we set him on fire. Besides, we should switch it up every now and again.
Bastards never stood a chance, did they?
Who?
Earthlings of any species.
Well, probably not. Make sure you stay hydrated, guys. I'm trying to make it a point to get a good bit of water. These stupid little ticks. Yes, I know they're not ticks. I know they're spiders.
Perhaps you can light the way with your scintillating personality.
Are you serious? We're gonna be in the dark?
If so, do it quietly. I don't think we're alone.
Actually, that arcane counter is really good. I do not like this. I do not like this one bit. We can't even go this way. We're playing a horror game now. Oh my gosh, it's one of these things. Just gotta stay on these guys. Probably explore this jump scare city over here. Okay, looks like we're supposed to go this way. Man, this is crazy. Just like flip the switch. This is not... Why are they putting these in here? Which way is the way? Forgetting about those spiders. Why it got to be dark? Oh, this seems like we're heading to the big baddie. Yeah, this seems like big baddie. What is that thing up there? Oh, it's a save point. So, here's a Volgi point. Might as well pop all our literature crystals and all that shit. Do we have enough to upgrade? I think we do. I think we go back and upgrade. This should put us enough to catch a level or two.
Greeting. This will be fun for both of us.
All right, 11 and a half.
As you wish.
Farewell. So, evade, gather, shorter sight, rest tax, nap, phone tax. Yeah, let's go ahead and get some more arcane damage.
What would you ask of this, please?
Let's go see.
Take your time.
Let's go see Old Thane. And upgrade the gear. I didn't even know that tip. I didn't know you could just press down and automatically go back to Nephilim's Respite. That's pretty amazing. So, the only problem with doing these seasons like this is I can't really gauge how I want to end the season. It's like, you either get like a really cool boss fight at the end, or you just get me running around looking like an idiot.
How can a hammer be of aiming to lay down a mighty hurt, are we?
So we could upgrade that to plus 3. I mean, that's primarily what we use. Maybe the chance score is freaking damage. Let's go ahead and upgrade this. Yo, look, we can even upgrade this higher now.
What beautiful.
Plus 4. There we go. I don't think we can upgrade our... This is the one we have on... So, is this the one we have on our whip?
Did you think it was possible? But now,
six demonic artifacts. Can we upgrade this one as well? Yeah, we can. That would increase that.
Did you think it was possible?
Might as well. Alright, now we're heading back. Got our upgrades. Probably should use these shards more, right?
Greetings.
So here
Please
we go.
Please take your time.
Yep. We're going there. So yeah. Like I was saying, so next episode, which will be the last episode for the season one of this, could just be me running around and getting lost and shit. You know, not enjoying it. Maybe getting frustrated at puzzles like I did that one that was so simple that I couldn't understand it for some reason. But let us move forward. What do some of these do? I think this gives us more defense, right? How long does it last, though? Oh, there's a little timer up there. Fortification shards do really good, actually. That's actually rather surprising. Wow. So we need a bug for up there. Dude, that arcane counter is so good. So we're gonna need purple explodey bugs. Dude, this fortification shard lasts forever. Oh, it's just you. Oh, I got stuck. Sorry if I'm getting quiet. I'm trying to focus on this guy. He's really not that much of a threat when he's by himself. Like, I don't know which way is progression. It's gotta be that way, right? Gotta stay on those boys. Wait, what is that? What? Rejuvenation core. What was that? Hello? What did I just get? What did I just get? Well, secrets are in my good friend Danny's words, video games. Always gotta seek out the video games. Oh, it's a human. Come on. I sense somewhere good. And the demonic artifact. Thank God for Vija games. Oh yeah, we still got like 10 minutes in this episode. I don't know. If the boss is up here, we might just, you know, save that for the next episode. I got a feeling the big boy's up here.
Mistress, your talisman.
We're close. This time you watch. You do not speak.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so I think we're gonna save the big bad for next time, then.
What would you ask of this will be fun for both as you wish.
I mean, a little bit of cool stuff, but I want to have something special for the end of this season. Taking down another sin, that would be pretty special.
This will be fun for both of us.
I really like this leveling up system. So I think we're pretty good on health right now. I say we boost our arcane counter again. That's neat. I never read any of this stuff. So, I mean, we should read this real quick. I mean, let's just take a minute. Alright, so this is the talisman we got from MB at the beginning. It allows the capture and imprisonment of the seven deadly sins. Glows when a sin's nearby. There's almost nothing that the seven fear on this or any other plane of existence. They will spread their poisonous destruction as long as they're able, with no thought given to their own preservation. But there's one thing. Something strikes terror in their rotten hearts. Captivity. Jeremiah. And then this is the Bridgestone. This is what allows us to transport the humans. All thing gave it to us. For a time, the Maker established and maintained many Bridgestones, making travel between realms and distant lands simple for all. However, as the war raged, things grew dire. They undid their work, rendering the stones useless. I said Jeremiah, that's Jemera. Then we got this stuff, but this just tells us what it does. Oh. Nephilim's respite, crafted by death. Imagine that. He gave this flask to his sister a gift long ago. Replenished itself by absorbing life energy from fallen enemies. Though not as skilled as the makers himself, death was an accomplished crafter in his own right. With most of the Nephilim focused on weapons of war, he endeavored to create something that gave life. When he finished, he offered the flask to Fury, whose penchant for seeking danger was well known. Okay, cool. We got all the weapons and stuff, you know. So, we got all this stuff. But, I think we're just gonna chill out before we go and fight the big boy. Yeah. I don't know why I'm losing my focus right here. But we're gonna save big boy over here for our last episode, which works out kind of perfectly. So, I mean, this one's give or take 24 minutes. So yeah, I do hope you're enjoying this series. I really like this game. I've been a big fan of the Darksiders game since Darksiders 1 back on, I think I played on Xbox 360. And it just really, I don't know, it really got to me. And then I really like the way they went with the second one, with it being kind of a looter based RPG style. And I don't know, I like that they've changed up each one. And I know Genesis is like top-down Diablo style kind of thing, but I do know that that is not Strife's official game. So hopefully we'll get a third-person game with Strife, where gunplay, you have a gunplay, and I know he has a melee short swords or something. I haven't played Genesis yet, but yeah, I have high hopes for that game too. And then maybe there'll be one game where you play as all the horsemen, and yeah, that would be pretty tight. But in the next one, we're gonna go and we're gonna confront this next sin right off the bat. That should give us a good place to end the season. I'm pretty sure that this is Sloth, the bug guy we saw way back when. And, yeah. That should, At least you took down that big mini-boss spider in this one. I mean, that was pretty exciting, right? But, yeah. So, I just got two things I want you guys to do. With everything that's going on right now, if you're in an infected area, just stay safe. And two, make sure you take care of yourselves and take care of each other. I know times are crazy with the Rona and other stuff going on. And, yeah, I just want everybody to be safe and try to love each other. That's what we need to do, love each other. Take care of each other and love each other is the way to move forward. And but that's what I try to preach at the end of every episode, so it's not much different from what I always say. That being said, I'll see you around.